All right, so I'm just gonna do a quick. I'm just gonna restart the recording real quick, just because I'm paranoid. So if something goes wrong, I don't have to do like half the game again. So I'll be back in a second. All right, I'm back. So this is basically what I dubbed the second half of the game, and I actually greatly prefer the second half. Honestly, this has some of my favorite levels. Like Frog Forest is a pretty good one. And the levels coming after this are some of my favorite levels in probably the whole series, honestly. And I don't know. I really like this part of the game. Had to fight the camera a little bit there, but it's fine. No, I'm not gonna. I don't bother with the normal bonus stages. There's no point, so I'm just gonna ignore that. But I don't know. What have I not talked about? It's hard to keep track of like every, like I'm doing this all in one sitting, and it's kind of hard to keep track of everything I've already mentioned. I guess one thing I haven't mentioned, like, I talked about the emblems earlier, and there's, like the adventure games, there are secondary objectives, but unlike the adventure games, there are only just one secondary objective for each mission. But since every character goes to the same stages, you technically still have a plethora of missions to do for each stage. All right, it's kind of scary when you have to deal with enemies on platforms like this. But yeah, you have secondary missions for each stage, and each team they basically have a type of secondary mission that's consistent throughout. Team Sonic, I think, are speedruns. Team Dark is kill this amount of enemies. Rose is get 200 rings, I think. And Team Chaotix is basically a harder version of the mission that's already present. Which in some instances makes it. I don't know. The secondary missions for Team Chaotix can be hit or miss. But yeah, if you're gonna 100% this game, that's when I really can like, I will really recommend like frequent breaks because, oh man, if you thought just doing the main story was could get exhausting doing four times, getting 100% is like way worse. Probably like three times worse. So yeah, just be wary. Like if you're gonna want to do that, you're gonna be in for the long haul. And again, take breaks because you don't want to get fatigued. Yeah, Mushroom Hill reference. Yeah. But yeah, since I've brought this up, I may as well talk about how I'm handling the other teams. Since you have to replay the game four times, what's gonna happen in the other teams is that I'm gonna bring two guests for each team, just to make it so we have some new, fresh opinions, things to have some other people's that we can just I can we can just I can just discuss the game with, and I was supposed to be getting those capsules game. I don't know why you didn't let me get them. But yeah, I'm gonna be getting guests in for the other teams because, quite frankly, I would run out of things to say fast for the other teams because again, you play the same game three more times after this. So yeah, getting guests is just gonna be the best idea for this. And again, fresh opinions, see where things go. At the moment, Last Story is going to be me alone, but I'm fully expecting me to get pressured into getting everyone into Final Story, so we'll just see what happens. Oh, man. And now we have Lost Jungle. This is a theme I do really like. And this is also the debut of one of the stronger enemies in the game. Thankfully, if I can get up here. Thankfully, you can ignore this guy, so it's not really much of an issue, but later on, there are times when you have to kill those enemies, and the power formation is the only form that can harm them. You can stun them with Thundershoot, but it's not going to do anything damage-wise. But, yeah, they're a thing. I don't mind them too much. It's the helmet variants, also these guys too. It's like the flying enemies, but every now and then they get spiky, and if you try and attack them then you'll just hurt yourself, so be careful. I don't mind these guys, because you can just mash attack with power, and you'll be all hunky-dory, I think that's the first death. Yeah, I'm not going to bother restarting. But one thing that is a little bit annoying is that every time you die, you lose all your power. Or your level ups. Which kind of makes you feel naked. So, yeah. But at the same time, it's one of those things that encourages you to not die. And just get better. Or not suck. And sometimes it's out of your control, sometimes you die to bullcrap, and it just happens sometimes. But yeah, I kind of like how this stage has kind of a, didn't mean to do that. It kind of encourages you to do some speed tricks. Well, not necessarily. Let me elaborate a little bit. Sometimes there are parts where there's like a big platform, for instance, and then there's a black frog. And the black frog detects you, it'll destroy the plant, and you'll have to go the long way. But if it doesn't see you, you can use the plant to kind of just skip a whole section, and kind of make the level go by a bit faster. And it rewards you for being. I don't know how to explain that very well, but. It feels rewarding, and, I need the key. It feels rewarding, if you manage to get past without the Black Frog seeing you, and whatnot. And it also rewards you for finding secret green frogs like this one, where they'll activate something, like this vine, for instance, to get you a secret one-up. So it's just nice stuff like that I like. Just simple concepts that are just satisfying, really. I'm not asking for crazy game-breaking stuff, really. And again, Sonic game philosophy of it's harder to stay on the top path, but it's a lot more worth it if you stay on there. I already have a Team Blast, but yeah, we would have gone that if we didn't already have one out. Oh, there's also this trick with Team Sonic specifically, where if you mash B, like, while standing, if you don't move the control stick and just mash B with power, you'll just do a little, you'll just keep doing that thrusting animation, which can be really helpful if you're, like, on, like, a small platform, and you don't want to fall, and stuff like that. So, you know. Oh, there's one topic I do want to discuss that I don't think has really been talked much at all. Okay, I'm gonna be careful. Okay. What the game intends you to do there is go around, I think you had to find a green, not green frog, but you find a switch that makes you have to do the light speed dash. And that's one of the most risky light speed dashes in the game. I've died to that more times than I can count. So yeah, if you're quick enough and get up before the plant disappears completely, then you should be golden. We're coming up to the end of the stage soon. Yeah, this looks kind of terrifying, but it isn't really that bad. Just also that there's dialogue that got cut because they were talking. But basically, when these vines go to the toppest, they can move. Dang it! Yeah, I'm getting an E rank. But when the vines go to the toppest top, they can the toppest part they can. Go to, that's when you press A and jump to the next one. Now, keep this in mind. If you're flying in flying formation for those things, it gets really janky and will often just. Okay, I'm just gonna do this so they can get the dialogue now. This time, there we go. I like how that's Sonic's reaction to something like this. It's really creepy, like, realistic looking, too. But yeah, look. If you just, What am I trying to say? If you just do it every time the vine or the swing things go to the top. Or their ascent, press A, do it every time and you'll be fine. That was a terrible run because of that duff. No, I'll take the D, that's better than I thought it would be. But yeah, don't use flying formation for that, use power or speed, because flying for whatever reason is just really janky for that. And it'll just probably get you killed, so just don't bother. Even if it feels safe, it's not. When would you ever say that, Sonic? But yeah, another team battle. And Zomg. Shadow's alive. Great line. Just fire. Doing this machine. I'll just do this. It's making the camera all wonky, but whatever. Okay, that's not gonna work. Why didn't you ask Rouge? Like, that's a topic for another time. Like the whole shadow amnesia thing. Definitely gonna cover that in the actual shadow playthrough. It's too much to just gloss over now. That wasn't even an A rank, what the hell? But now we're getting to some of my favorite levels. Oh man, like, oh man, Sonic game, Sonic doesn't, as far as I'm, like, okay, so, Adventure 2 had stuff like Pumpkin Hill and whatnot, and Shadow the Hedgehog had, Cryptic Castle, so I guess, like, just from, like, the Adventure era, if you wanna, like, classify this, is, I mean, I kind of do classify these Heroes in Shadow as adventure games in a technical sense. Like, they're part of the same storyline. They're clear continuations. So I just kind of find it funny how starting with Adventure 2, like, they just had, like, a haunted, like a haunted theme level for each game up to Shadow. I don't think 06 had anything like that. Unleashed had those ghosts in a mission from the Night of the Werehog, short. But, yeah, you know what I'm saying. I don't know, I'm losing my train of thought. But point is though, I really like the atmosphere in these next two levels. I really enjoyed the level design and the music's pretty good too. And there's some neat little shortcuts you can do to skip some sections if you're careful with your rail grinding jump. Do 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 do. So if you just jump off here, you can skip that. And you get that feather item to Team Blast, screw this. You get a feather icon to get your flight meter back. For the longest time, I thought it was a hand, but no, it's a feather or like a wing, something along those lines. Dang it! Didn't mean to do that. Alright. But yeah, after Shadow, they haven't really done a level motif like this for quite a while. So I'd like to see them do something with it again, because this and especially Mystic Mansion, which is the level after this, some of my favorite levels in the series, personally. And I really dig the, the what was it, the level generations level mod someone made. All right, that was slow, but whatever. Indeed it has. And yeah, every time the castle flips, the music when the castle is flipped upside down, it changes and is a lot more, I guess, mysterious and wacky. I don't know how to explain it, but it's cool. I like it. It gives me it's like how Stone Tower Temple, when it's upside down in Majora's Mask, it sounds a lot more weird. I'm bad at describing music, but it sounds cool. I like that they did that, and it just makes the whole weird supernatural thing feel a bit more pronounced, I guess. I hope I'm making sense, because this is really hard for me to explain. But either way, indeed he does. And if you do this, oh, it's Metal Sonic, which is foreshadowing the actual final boss. So you know. Now we're gonna run down the castle. This is pretty cool, but it does feel a little bit janky. Kind of reminds me of Going Down from SA1. But not quite as exciting, because the music doesn't change, and it's a lot shorter. But I don't know, similar kind of thing. Huzzah. Indeed it was, Sonic. Now this... Okay, I just want you to... I'm just going to let the music play out for a little bit, because this is actually amazing. Well, as soon as these guys stop chatting our ears off, you just listen to this funky beat. You surprised me. Okay, I don't know why it's looping like that, but it's been a while since I played the full actual game, so maybe like it changes. There we go. Triggers these guys, but yeah, this theme is amazing. Like it uses. Like the well-known, like, creepy kind of vibe, and like doorbells general like haunted house kind of sounds, and just makes a really funky music track with it, and it's so good. I think that, okay, because, okay, so the actual RST version of this track just goes to one part to the next, or what verse, or whatever you want to call it. But I think it's, for the actual game, it's dependent on where you are in the level. That's actually kind of cool. I never knew that. But yeah, I love the music here. I love the gimmick with the switches and how it changes the level design. I like the idea of being in a really weird haunted mansion, because it's not really done in, it hasn't really been done in Sonic. Like, Cryptic Castle is the closest you get after this, and it's a haunted level, but it's not the same kind of thing as this. And I don't know, I like it because it's unique. What can I say? I just really like this level. It's really fun to play. It is a bit on the narrow side, but still. There is a version of the stage though that is not the greatest, I'll admit. But that's not for a long time. Alright, I want to be quick here because... Die! Oh, come on, really? Okay, I guess we're going to have to fight this guy properly. So this is the introduction to the helmet, dudes. And what you want to do, you can do this for the regular guys, but it's mandatory for these ones, basically, is after they do their spinning move, you can use Thunder Shoot or other moves like slam dunk move to make them fall on the ground for a little bit, and you can only hit their green light spot that you can to damage them. And that's covered with the helmets, which you need to do something to get that flung off. And yeah. Yeah, it does change depending on the area. Man, that is so cool. Yeah, those things, like, rarely ever hit you, if ever. Whee! Okay, there was something I was going to talk about earlier, but I got sidetracked. So, my thing with Sonic games is that... Okay, that's fine, whatever. My thing with Sonic games is that I don't necessarily have to be going, like, Mach 200 at all times. My opinion for, how a good Sonic playstyle is, how does the game flow? Is it, like, is it fun to play? Can you go from one action to the next in a satisfying and clean manner? I'm probably not explaining the story well, but basically what I mean is what I need to do Well, first things first, before I try and explain myself better, this is one of the worst parts of the game. So you want to be careful here, because sometimes Knuckles and Tails will just destroy the Jack-O-Lanterns prematurely, or your homing attack will mess up. So the best option is just to hold the jump burn as, like, for a long period of time. Don't rush it. Just take your time with it, and you should be safe if you do it like that. But Anyways, what I was saying, my thing with Sonic is that if it flows well and is fun to play, then that's basically what I'm asking for, and I admit that to me is considered a good play style. I'm not necessarily asking for like super fast speed, like 24/7, like Unleashed or whatever. But what I think a play style needs is a good sense of flow, satisfaction, and again with the arcade feel, it needs to feel good to get a good score in. And going back to like the SA2, like the Sonic and Shadow stages self-explanatory, but the mech stages, yeah, they're a lot slower, but the way they work, like you're constantly shooting enemies, you're getting a bunch of points, and you're quickly doing that again and again, and it flows really well, and you're constantly doing that and getting a bunch of points, and it's satisfying to do. And with the treasure hunting, you're constantly like running around figuring out what the hint is talking about, and you're just going to the next location for the emerald, and it has a good sense of speed with the controls and whatnot. And I hope I'm kind of making sense. And like, I guess another thing with like the Werehog, for instance, yeah, it's combat a lot more combat focused, and you're not as fast. I missed two emeralds, what the hell. But at the same time, that you can, if you care to learn, you can chain combos together in a satisfying way. It flows really well, and you can do some little tricks to make platforming a bit faster, and stuff like that. Like, again, it doesn't have to be super fast all the time, but if what I'm doing flows together really well and it's fun and satisfying to do, that's what I consider a good Sonic playstyle. But that's just me.